15 years have now passed since I presented my report on children in armed conflict to the UN Secretary General. That report described the shocking levels of violence visited on the world's most vulnerable citizens, its children. It documented what I described as the unregulated terror inflicted on children trapped in armed conflict, the killing, the maiming, the sexual violence, the forced recruitment of child soldiers. And it called on the international community to act urgently and decisively. Over the past 15 years, we have seen some positive developments. The United Nations is far more actively involved in monitoring violence against children caught up in armed conflict. And many resolutions have been passed by the Security Council calling on governments to respect the human rights of children. But monitoring and resolutions alone do not protect children. UNESCO's report, The Hidden Crisis, Armed Conflict and Education, leaves no room for doubt that the unregulated terror continues. If anything, the levels of violence targeted against children may have got worse. As the report documents, physical attacks against school children, rape and sexual violence, and the destruction of school buildings are still widely used as weapons of war. Moreover, the culture of impunity surrounding these activities speaks volumes about the failure of governments and the international community to live up to their human rights obligations. The UNESCO report documents the devastating effects of armed conflict on education. But the report is not just an analysis of problems. It is a call to action. It is a call to governments and the international community to hold to account those responsible for violating the human rights of the world's children. It is a call to aid donors to step up to the plate and do more to support communities struggling in the face of overwhelming odds to give their children an education. And it is a call to every government in the world to use education as a force for building peace. 15 years ago, my report had one very simple message for the international community. I quote, "The time has come to call a halt." I'm afraid that I can't think of a better message to leave with you today. Thank you.